Psalm 119 verse 105 says, the word of God is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. That tells you that everything that you can ever want or need, instruction, guidance, clarity, understanding, faith, is all written in the word of God. But how many of us have found time to read the Bible? We spend perhaps so much more time following the news. I've seen people on social media say, I am waiting for NCDC to announce the new rates before I go to bed. What a thought. What an idea. What a thing to put in your heart and go to bed. Where you should read the Bible and pray and meditate and go to bed so that he can open up unto you instruction, direction, and vision in your dreams as you sleep. How many of us are conscious that this same God that has kept me since I was born, this same God that has kept me through all other incidents, is able to keep me even through this season? In spite of all of the things that are happening around the world, we need to find peace. And that's why John chapter 14 says, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God and believe also in me. Don't be afraid. Don't be angry. And I say, be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whether the church saw it or not, whether people prophesied it or not, it doesn't matter. But what rings true is that God is the supreme being. He alone knows the end from the beginning. He alone knows tomorrow. We might pontificate. We might share prophecies. We might say this. We might say that. Truly knows what is going to happen. And he has promised us that we should relax, that the plans that he has for us are plans of good. So why are you worried? Why are you not listening intently? Why are you not seeking out the voice of God? Say, what is God saying at a time like this? The songwriter says, I have no other argument. I have no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died, and that he died for me. That should be your confession. I'm not interested in any argument. I'm not interested in any logic. I'm not interested in any conspiracy theory. It is enough that Jesus died for me. It is enough that Jesus has told me, let not your heart be troubled. I will hold on to that irrespective of what may happen, because I know that my end will be sure greater and better than my beginning. That at the end of this era, at the end of this season, my testimony will be full. Whose report do you believe? Finally, you know, I see people forward typing and sharing on WhatsApp. When you are getting worried about the noise and the headlines are getting scarier, and remember John chapter 14 verse 1 as well, and picture Jesus saying to you, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe in me also. That's a double assurance. Believe in God the Father, believe in God the Son. And that's God the Holy Spirit, the third person in Trinity, whispering afresh to you to say, let not your heart be troubled. Let's pray. Just as I am without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come. I come. Let us pray very quickly. Just if you don't know Christ, ask him to come into your life at this time. Say, Lord Jesus, I confess that I've been quite aloof. I've been far away. I've missed my way. I come back in repentance to you, Lord Jesus, this morning. And I ask that you accept me and that you reign over my life, even as I submit myself afresh to you as my Lord and my Savior. Help me to find your voice at this time. Show me the way that I should go, in the name of Jesus Christ. The hymn writer said, God never yet forsook at need the soul that trusted him. You're going to ask God the last prayer. Please show me the way that I should go from now on. I want you to give me clarity about the decisions that I need to make, the changes in my life that I need to bring to bear. Please show me the way. Show me the way. Show me the way. I don't want to come out of this season and this era the same way I entered. I know he's able. He's able. I know he's able. I know my God is able to carry me through.